What's up, y'all? It's your boy, Ace Operative. And today, I would like to talk about Pokemon Sword and Shield. First off, let's get this out the way. Who in their development team decided to name the game Sword and Shield? We went from colors, we went to stones, and then we went back to colors, and then we went straight to the freaking planets, and then now we weapons, my guy. I'm just like you're saying, there better be a deep, and I do mean a deep story to explain all of this, because I'm just like you're saying, Sword and Shield, why? But the world looks freaking beautiful, bro. I am so glad we are off the 3DS and we are actually on to very freaking good hardware. Hardware in which we're able to record. The way in which they have done this game visually, the visual presentation looks unbelievable. Very freaking good. The only, here are some of my expectations. I would like a day and night cycle. I think that's going to be almost a given, because there should be some Pokemon you can catch during the day, some Pokemon you can only catch at night. And I feel like the Gen 8 Pokemon aren't 100% done yet, because all throughout this trailer, we saw Pokemon from the previous gens, and that's what made me at question until we saw our starters. Bro, our starters, I don't know how to feel about our starters, bro. Because when we first saw the first starter, which was the Fire-type Score Bunny, I was like, you're saying, okay, he looks pretty cool. I could get behind having another Fire-type as my starter, because this has been like my trend when it came down to star Pokemon. In Gen 1, I chose Charmander. Gen 2, I chose Cyndaquil. Gen 3, I chose Treecko. Gen 4, I chose Chimchar. Gen 5, I chose Tepig. Gen 6, I chose Fennekin. Gen 7, I had chose Litten. And so now in Gen 8, I'm choosing another freaking fire type. I've been on the fire type train for like a good minute. That's why I was like, you're thinking, okay, what are my other options? But so far, I'm liking the fire type bunny rabbit more than all the other starters. I know there's going to be other people that are going to go for the monkey. They're going to have some people that go, a lot of people from what I've seen on Twitter, they're going for the lizard. But I'm just like, you're saying, just the fire type, they always make the fire type look pretty cool. Even though I could just tell that this dude is going to have a firefighting type of aspect to him.
Your secret stuff.
13 hours till I land, happy.
But we do not know that, but I'm going to stay on this hype train for this particular Pokemon until the freaking end. But I'm not gonna lie, on Twitter, when you go on Twitter after that direct, suckers went ham. I could not believe some of the artists had already drew some of the starters. Like, this direct hasn't even been out for like for less than an hour, and suckers already drew the art of these Pokemon. And there was some questionable art. Some people compared some previous franchises to this art, and I'm just like, you're saying some of the art was very questionable. And I think coming down to the final thing that I'm wondering, the champion most likely is still going to be Cynthia, but you know, she'll be like a guest character, but they're going to actually have a champion of this region, unless they pull a Sun and Moon and make us the champion all over again. I'm excited for Pokemon Gen 8. It's been a long time coming. We can finally put Pokemon Let's Go, Pikachu, and Eevee, you know, to bed. They did what they needed to do. They just was there to hold us over until Gen 8 got their confirmation, and now we can look forward to the future of what Pokemon is going to freaking be. And I can't wait for them to go more in depth on some of the mechanics of this Pokemon game, but I guess we'll find all that out in E3. Thank you all for watching. Please let me know what you guys think about this in the comment section below. Till next time, guys. Operatives, move out.